Good morning. Welcome in the name of Jesus Christ to McCownville United Methodist Church. As United Methodist Christians, we are called to make disciples of Jesus Christ for the transformation of the world. If you're attending from home, you may post your prayers on the Facebook feed. We'll continue to uplift your prayers this morning and throughout the week. An announcement and notes on the flyer is available in the back by the entry. If you would like the church to be in touch with you, fill out a contact us card and leave it in the offering plate. The offering this morning will be collected at the end of worship. During the service, there will be a time to reflect on your offering in response to God's blessings. Then as you exit, leave your offering in the plates at the end of the back pews, or you can mail it to the church office or donate online. And also this morning, instead of Pastor Jeff Landon, we welcome Nancy Goddard as our lay minister with us this morning. Next, in announcements, today is the first day back with Sunday school. So after the children's time, please follow Kim Keen afterwards and down the hall. And I think it's third grade through high school. Is that sounds kindergarten? Thank you. A couple other announcements coming up in a few weeks. The Brooks Chicken Barbecue, the sign-up sheet is at the back. That's September 28th from 2 to 6 p.m. The movie night is the week before that, September 21st, Saturday here at 7 p.m. And one other's here also in late September, the pumpkins are coming. Again, it's in the announcements at the back, but they'll be looking for volunteers, I believe at 4 p.m. to help unload, provide refreshments, and drive a forklift truck. That sounds like the interesting part. And finally, even next week, is a welcome back luncheon immediately following the 10 o'clock service. If you would join in singing from the Black Hymnal, Cry of My Heart, song number 2165, if you'll stand and sing. Please remain standing, if you would, and join along in the opening prayer. O Trinity, fill our weakness with your strength. Bind up our brokenness with your unity. Calm our fears with your peace. Let us be about the tasks of your love. Use us to build a holy place where healing and caring and joy blend in the tones of worship to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Please be seated.
Well, the young disciples, come join us. I'm going to ask you to come all the way to the very top step. Are there any other? Oh, here come our front. Great. Glad to see all of you. So I'm going to ask for you to sit, because we're going to do something this morning. So I need you to be over here, sitting on the very top part. And I brought some cardboard with me today, and I'm wondering if we can all work together to build a wall. Would you help me do that? Would you help me build a wall? So we need to get everybody up here, and we're going to build a wall going this way, like this. Okay? So here's a brick for you, and a brick for you, and I have lots more with me, and a brick for you, and pass them on back. Pass those bricks back so everybody gets a brick, because we want to build this wall to the best of our ability. Does everyone, we still have more bricks we need, because we have more here. Does anybody else need a brick? Does everyone have one? Okay, so I want you to build, put one on top of this one, and then the next person will come and build, put the brick on top of that, can you come up? So we're just gonna have to scooch around each other, okay? So sometimes we adults build walls. We got you to build this wall, come on. Come build the wall with me, we're gonna build this wall, thank you. Sometimes we adults build walls to separate us from people who are different from us. And sometimes we adults build walls to keep some people out. And sometimes we adults build walls to keep some people in. In Bible times, the Jewish people had certain laws that they had to obey. And people who weren't Jewish, called Gentiles, didn't have to obey these laws. So that's one way they were different. That's one way they were separate. So Paul, the Apostle Paul, wrote a letter to the people in the church in Ephesus. And Ephesus is located on the western coast of modern-day Turkey. And he said to the people in Ephesus that because of Jesus, we don't need to have anything separate us. We don't need any walls to keep us apart from each other. Paul said that God loves all of us, and God wants us to talk together and to work together and to play together and to love each other and be friends. Now we have this wall of bricks. Are you all good at pretending? Can we pretend that this wall of bricks goes all the way from the top of the sanctuary down to the floor and from one wall all the way to the other wall? Can we pretend that this wall of bricks encompasses this entire room? So if you're on that side of the wall and I'm on this side of the wall, would we be able to talk to each other like we are now? No. Would we be able to play together? Would we be able to work together? Would we be able to share with each other? So how could we? How could we talk to each other and work together and play together? What's one thing we could do? Any ideas? Could we knock down the wall? Do you think that would be one way for us to talk together and to work together and to play together, would be to knock that wall over? Do you want to try? You guys want to try? Go ahead, knock it over. Knock it over. There we go, good job. Did a great job. So in our Bible story for today, Paul tells us that Jesus helps us tear down the walls that separate us. God loves all of us. No matter what we look like, or how we dress, or how we think, or what language we speak, God loves us just the way we are, and God wants us to love each other and not have anything separate us from God's love. So this week, I want you to think about ways that you can be kind and loving and play with people and share and be close together the way God wants us to be. So after our prayer, you may go to Sunday school. So let's have a prayer, please. Dear God, thank you for Jesus. And thank you that because of Jesus, we don't need to have anything separate us from you and from each other. We love you, Lord. Amen. Have a great time in Sunday school, and thank you so much for coming. Oh, and we get to have a snack, right? Is that the best time of children's message? I promise you I will pick these up later. Our hymn, our next hymn is Blessed Be the Tie That Binds in the red hymnal number 557. Please stand as you are able.
Please be seated. What joys and concerns would you share with God and one another this morning? Continued prayers, please, for Pastor Jeff as he heals from his hip replacement surgery. Are there others? So on the screen, you will see that when you hear the words, "In Christ, we are joined together," please respond with, "As a dwelling place for God." Are we all good with that? Okay, super. Please join your heart with mine in prayer. God of Jesus Christ and our God, we are no longer strangers and aliens, but citizens with the saints belonging to you, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets. In Christ, we are joined together as a dwelling place for God. We pray for those who have been called or elected as leaders, that they may be guided by your voice. In Christ, we are joined together as a dwelling place for God. We pray for those who are poor and in need of assistance, and for ourselves, that we may tenderly care for them. In Christ, we are joined together as a dwelling place for God. We pray for the victims of war and other forms of violence, that we may be good news for them, both in word and in deed. God, please bring an end to the wars across your world. We pray for peace, Lord God. In Christ, we are joined together as a dwelling place for God. Holy God, we pray for an end to gun violence in our country, for the families of those who died in Winden, Georgia, and for the children everywhere who have been, are, or will be traumatized by shootings in their schools. Please, Lord God, bring an end to the gun violence that has seeped into our nation. In Christ, we are joined together as a dwelling place for God. We pray for the sick and the infirmed, and for Pastor Jeff as he recovers from his hip replacement surgery. We ask your healing and your peace to be upon him, that he would grow stronger each day. And Lord, we pray for those we name silently in our hearts before you now. In Christ, we are joined together as a dwelling place for God. Good Shepherd, Lord of righteousness, bind us together through the cross of Christ and break down the dividing walls between us. Be our peace, and by your Holy Spirit, renew our citizenship in your kingdom. We pray as Jesus taught us, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen."
The scripture reading this morning is from the book of Ephesians, chapter 2, verses 11 through 22. Therefore, remember that formerly you, who are Gentiles by birth and called uncircumcised by those who call themselves the circumcision, which is done in the body by human hands, remember that at that time you were separate from Christ, excluded from citizenship in Israel and foreigners to the covenants of the promise, without hope, without God in the world. But now in Christ Jesus, you who once were far away have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For he himself is our peace, who has made the two groups one and has destroyed the barrier, the dividing wall of hostility, by setting aside in his flesh the law with its commands and regulations. His purpose was to create in himself one new humanity out of the two, thus making peace, and in one body to reconcile both of them to God through the cross by which he put to death their hostility. He came and preached peace to you who were far away and peace to those who were near, for through him we both have access to the Father by one Spirit. Consequently, you are no longer foreigners and strangers, but fellow citizens with God's people and also members of his household, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Jesus Christ himself as the chief cornerstone. In him, the whole building is joined together and rises to become a holy temple in the Lord. And in him, you too are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his Spirit. May the Lord bless the reading, hearing, understanding of his holy word. Thanks.
The Sunday school class launched into a discussion of how much darkness there was in the world. War, hate, hunger, homelessness. When will it all end? A woman asked. Her question recalled the story of the rabbi who asked his students a question. When does night end and day begin? One student asked, is it the moment you're able to perceive the difference between an olive tree and a fig tree? No, said the rabbi, that's not it. Is it the moment you can tell the difference between a sheep and a dog? Asked another. No, said the rabbi, that's not it either. So the students asked, then rabbi, tell us, when does night end and day begin? The rabbi carefully looked the students in the eyes and slowly said, it is the moment you look into the face of your brother, your sister, when you look into the face, I'm sorry, I'm gonna start that again. It is the moment you look into the face of a stranger and recognize that it is really the face of your brother, your sister, your friend. In the ancient world, Jews were separated from Gentiles by physical, racial, religious, cultural, and social barriers. There was no love between the two groups. In our scripture reading for this morning in Paul's letter to the Ephesians, he begins by reminding the Gentiles that formerly they were complete outsiders, Jew and Gentile, circumcised and uncircumcised, separated by physical distinctions, but separated by spiritual distinctions as well. Belief in one God versus belief in many gods. Belonging to God's family versus being an outsider. Chosen versus not chosen. Hopeful versus hopeless. Barriers, walls, are built one brick at a time. The talk of division and the wall of hostility that separate us, just as Jews and Gentiles were separated. Ours, however, is a separation born from differences in age, appearance, political beliefs, sexual identity, economic status, race, religion, to name a few. These barriers, these walls built one brick at a time, are figuratively actions taken, words spoken, love withheld. A bitter word, a hateful comment, a cold shoulder. Brick after brick is laid one upon the other until the wall seems so high and so thick and so wide it is impossible to change. But then comes the miracle of Christ. Christ's death on the cross is the means of peace with God for all, for Jew and Gentile alike, without distinction. Through this new way, God is accessible to everyone. The once alienated Jew and Gentile are now reconciled in Christ and formed into a home for God. The two parties became one, not only by Christ, but in Christ. All who belong to Christ have a common bond, which is deeper and stronger than any of our differences of race, or religion, or color, or status, or background, or sexual preference, or political ideology. All are one in Christ. The miracle of Christ. Listen again to Paul's words beginning in verse 14. Christ is our peace. He made both Jews and Gentiles into one group. With his body, he broke down the barrier of hatred that divided us. He canceled the detailed rules of the law so that he could create one new person out of the two groups, making peace. He reconciled them both as one body to God by the cross, which ended the hostility to God. What Paul is saying here is powerful. It is Christ who unites us. It is Christ who tears down the walls that separate us. It is Christ who helps us look into the face of a stranger and see the face of our sister, our brother, our friend, not our enemy. It is this one body, our bodies, who house the temple of God by the indwelling of the Holy Spirit. It is not our age, or our religion, or our race, or our intelligence, or our political views. Rather, it is who dwells inside us. It is the Holy Spirit constantly working within us, empowering, equipping, and enabling us to be the people that God intends for us to become like Christ in our thoughts and in our words and in our deeds. John Wesley, the founder of Methodism, proclaimed, "If your heart is as my heart, take my hand." Wesley is saying that we can be unified even if we should disagree. Because if our hearts proclaim Jesus is Lord and Savior, if our hearts proclaim Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, if our hearts proclaim Jesus is the Christ, the Anointed One of God, then can we not take one another's hands and be unified and walk this journey of faith and of life together? Steve Green wrote a song called Let the Walls Come Down. And the refrain goes like this. Let the walls come down. Let the walls come down. Let the walls that divide us and hide us come down. If in Christ we agree, let us seek unity. Let the walls come down. Yes, Lord Jesus, let the walls come down. Sister Thea Bowman met the risen Christ, and she invited him in. She was a Roman Catholic nun, the granddaughter of a slave, and the daughter of a physician who was not allowed to practice medicine in the hospital of his hometown in Mississippi. Sister Thea worked tirelessly to tear down the walls that divide us. She worked tirelessly to unite us, to make us one. Sister Thea was invited to speak to the National Conference of Roman Catholic Bishops. She began by asking them, "Do you know what it means to be Black and to be in the church today? I want to tell you what it is like." Then she stood back from the microphone, standing there with great dignity, quiet for the longest time. Slowly, she began to sing. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child, a long way from home. At the end of her speech, in which she talked about the Roman Catholic Church becoming more inclusive of all peoples, 250 bishops stood, held hands, and swayed from side to side, singing, "We shall overcome." Notre Dame University planned to award Sister Thea their highest medal of honor at their commencement ceremony, but she was not there to receive it. She died of cancer a few weeks before the commencement. When the school awarded her the medal posthumously, they read some of the words that Sister Thea's students often heard her speak. Be Black. Be white, be male, be female, be priest, be laity, be single, be married, but be one in Christ. The moment we look into the face of a stranger and recognize that it is really the face of our sister, our brother, our friend, is when night ends in our world and day begins. So be it. Amen and amen. Please stand as you are able for the song Bind Us Together. It will be in the small black hymnal, The Faith We Sing, number 2226. Thank you. Do you remain stand? Oh, you sit. Okay, please be seated. Thanks. Let us take a moment of silent reflection for the opportunity and the privilege of returning to God what belongs to God. Precious God, thank you for filling us with every spiritual grace that we might be a blessing for others. Consecrate the gifts we offer for the increase of your love. May they bring blessings to others and praise to your glorious name. Amen. Receive the benediction. God, who longs to continue in us the work begun in Jesus, let us who have been reconciled by Christ become reconcilers for Christ. Send us who have found peace in God's home to make peace in God's world. Amen.